Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the future uploads. Hello everyone. In this part of the video, we are going to see the provisions of maintenance under Parsi law. So on this topic, what will be the questions asked in the question paper? It will be discuss the various provisions for maintenance under Parsi Marriage and Divorce Act, or what are the provisions under which maintenance can be granted under Parsi Marriage Act. Questions asked in exam: 1. What are the provisions for maintenance under Parsi law? 2. Discuss the interim and permanent maintenance under Parsi Marriage and Divorce Act 1936. This is not a full-length question asked for 16 marks. It will be asked only for 8 marks. But every mark counts, and 8 mark questions are also very much important. Rather, while writing a full-length answer of 16 marks, instead of that, answering 2 questions of 8 marks fetches more marks than the full-length question of 16. And that's why it is always better to answer short questions more than the long answers, even though how much better you can write that answer. Coming back to maintenance part, while writing this answer, first we should write the synopsis. What will be the synopsis for this entire answer? It will be introduction, then meaning of maintenance and definitions, then interim maintenance, permanent maintenance, difference between interim maintenance and permanent maintenance, and then conclusion. So by these 6 points, the answer will be complete answer. To write this, first of all, to introduce the topic, we should say that maintenance is a concept evolved in the law to enable the weaker party to be financially equal to the other spouse, so that that spouse will not be left or having a superior hand in a position because it's that party is just a financially having superior hand. And that's why this concept of maintenance evolved through time. Now, while deciding this maintenance, what is basically maintenance? Unfortunately, maintenance is not defined under Parsi Marriage and Divorce Act. For that, we have to go to Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act. Section 3 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act provides the definition for maintenance. If you closely look the maintenance definition, it states that maintenance includes. So the word here is includes and not maintenance means. What does it mean? It means that it is inclusive definition and not exhaustive one. Many factors can be included later on, and that's why maintenance includes provision for food, clothing, shelter or residence, education or medication and medical treatment. So all these 5 things are included in the definition of maintenance. Many more things also can be considered by the court while granting maintenance to one party. So this becomes the definition clause and the meaning point of your synopsis. Maintenance is not defined in Parsi Marriage Act. Maintenance is defined under Section 3 of the Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act. Maintenance includes provision for food, clothing, residence, education, and medical treatment. The third point of the synopsis was interim maintenance. Now, interim maintenance is given under Section 39 of Parsi Marriage and Divorce Act 1936. So, what does it say? First of all, it states that in any suit pending under that. What does it mean? It means that simplicitor application for maintenance under Section 39 cannot be filed. There has to be a case pending under that. The cases can be restitution of conjugal rights, judicial separation, nullity, or divorce. So in any of these 4 proceedings, an application under Section 39 seeking interim maintenance can be filed. Who can file that application? Either husband or wife can file such application. What is the criteria? First of all, husband or wife seeking that interim maintenance should not have sufficient income to her support basically. Here it does not mean that they don't have any income. Either they don't have any income or the income which is earned by such person is not sufficient for their overall support, and that's why they are coming before the court to seek maintenance. Now this interim maintenance is granted during the pendency of the proceedings. So whenever an application is made and until that petition, whether it is restitution of conjugal rights, judicial separation, nullity or divorce, is finally heard and decided, till that period basically the maintenance is granted, and that maintenance is called as interim maintenance. Interim maintenance is always either weekly or monthly. It is never a lump sum amount of say 1 lakh rupees, 2 lakh rupees permanently, no. It is always monthly amount. And what are the various factors to be considered while granting maintenance? First is income of both the parties. Secondly, expenses incurred by both individually. Then the third important factor is standard of living, which is the most important factor here. Then properties owned by them and whether there is income fetched from such properties. And there are various other factors as well. So considering all these factors, interim maintenance is decided. While deciding interim maintenance, litigation expenses also can be granted by the court. What is litigation expenses? Litigation expenses is expenses for the entire process of law. So a person has to find a lawyer, draft a petition, file that petition in the court, then later on file such documents, and to prove the petition, to argue it, to file various applications, there is an expense. And for that expense, if the person is unable to maintain oneself or to afford to pay litigation expenses, that expenses also can be sought from the court under the same section, that is section 39. Section 39, interim maintenance, has to be made in the proceedings under the Act. Both husband or wife can file for interim maintenance. Who has no independent income sufficient for support, litigation expenses also can be granted. Weekly or monthly sum. Factors to be considered: income of both the parties, expenses, properties, standard of living, etc. Now we will see the concept of permanent maintenance. Section 40 deals with permanent alimony and maintenance, and it has various factors. So what does the section say? Again, the section says that in any petition or suit pending under that. So for that matter, there has to be a petition either for restitution of conjugal rights, judicial separation, nullity or divorce pending before the court. Then only an application under section 40 can be made by any husband or wife. Who can file it? Again, husband or wife having no means sufficient for their support can file for permanent alimony or maintenance. While granting permanent alimony or maintenance, various factors are considered by the court. Now, permanent maintenance is granted at the end of the trial. So, when either these four proceedings, restitution of conjugal rights, judicial separation, nullity or divorce are over, so at the time of delivering judgment, permanent maintenance is granted. So at that time, the entire evidence is before the court, and therefore, after hearing everything and after rather deriving everything from the evidence, the court reaches to the conclusion first of all whether to grant permanent alimony or maintenance or not, and what should be the amount. While granting that amount, it can be of course monthly or a gross sum also, meaning the court can grant 10,000, 15,000, 20,000 per month as permanent maintenance after the trial is over, or the court can grant also 5 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees, 15 lakh rupees lump sum amount to the party. It depends upon the thinking process of the court. So basically, the maintenance which is granted after the trial is called as permanent maintenance. And while deciding permanent maintenance, the factors are a bit more than it was in interim maintenance. First of all, income of both the parties, expenses of both the parties, if there is anyone dependent on them, if there is someone dependent, then up to what extent that person is dependent, then what is the standard of living of the parties, and most importantly, what is the conduct of the parties. So conduct of the parties is also seen by the court while giving maintenance. If the wife or husband is living in adultery, then definitely the court decides whether to grant maintenance or not depending upon the conduct of the person. Here the conduct plays a much important role. Now once permanent alimony or maintenance is granted, whether it can be modified, and the answer is yes. Under section 40 itself, an application, simpliciter application for modification of maintenance can be filed by the parties. Here, while filing for modification, there does not have to be a petition pending already. So even if that petition is disposed of and permanent alimony or maintenance is granted by the court, still an application for modification, simpliciter, can be filed by the husband or wife on changed circumstances. Section 40, permanent maintenance, to be filed in any proceedings under the Act, either by husband or wife, monthly or gross sum is granted by the court. Factors to be considered are income of both the parties, property of both the parties, conduct of the parties, standard of living, etc. Maintenance granted can be modified if an application is made for change in the circumstances. The next point to write is difference between interim maintenance and permanent maintenance. To differentiate, we can say interim maintenance, first difference is section number. Interim maintenance is granted under section 39, permanent maintenance is granted under section 40. Then interim maintenance is granted during the pendency of proceeding. Permanent maintenance is granted after the proceedings are over. This is the main difference actually between interim maintenance and permanent maintenance. Then while granting interim maintenance, either weekly or monthly sum is granted. While granting in permanent maintenance, monthly or gross sum can be granted by the court. Here again there is a point of difference. And then while considering the factors, conduct of the parties is seen in permanent maintenance, while deciding interim maintenance, conduct of the parties is never seen. So conduct of the parties is the main point of difference. So all these can be the points of difference. You can definitely add more differences if you find them, but I could have summarized these four, which are really main differences. To conclude, we can say that under section 39 or under section 40, interim alimony or permanent alimony respectively can be granted by the Honorable Court. Either husband or wife can make an application, and after deciding various factors, the court can grant either permanent or interim maintenance to such parties. This can be the basic conclusion to be written for this answer. Also, you can write that maintenance granted can be modified by the court later on due to change in circumstances. Same video in Marathi language is also uploaded on YouTube. Please follow the link given in the description box.
If you have liked the video, please give a thumbs up. Video on various topics are going to be uploaded on YouTube. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the future uploads. Thank you.